Coach Ryan, right now currently the Buckeyes in fifth. It's going to get interesting tonight. The medal matches are over. A couple guys come back and take third. Nate battles back. You know, that's a tough loss last night in the semis. Obviously, Bo, that's a tough loss in the semis. Those guys come back and take third. What was the message to the guys?
I mean, the message is always the same thing. You represent yourself and the organization. And if you do not want to represent yourself, if you're just not in the mood to, nobody cares if you're in the mood to or not, because you're part of a program that's bigger than you. And that's not an easy thing to do, what they did, as you know. Both heartbreaking losses. Heartbreaking in these guys. And we're dejected. And you get some sleep and you wake up in the morning. They can see the team score. If we can't get first, we can get second. If we can't get second, you get third. If you can't get third, you get fourth. If you can't get fourth, you get fifth. Every point mattered, and both those guys did a nice job.
Looking at that barn burner of a match between Terrell, kitchen sink guy,
Yeah. Throws
everything he's got at you. Nate, being Nate, Yeah. Never stops moving, doesn't get caught on his back. How do you coach a guy to win a match like that?
Well, I think credit to Terrell. I mean, he embraced his last match. I mean, it was fun to watch. You know, he went after somebody that was probably heavily favored and made it a really fun match. So credit to him. I mean, Nate's just Nate. Didn't get flustered. Stayed in position. Wrestled every second. You know, I thought he could have been a little more physical, Nate. I mean, he did. Did get injured in the match before. He hurt his shoulder a little bit, so I think that might have affected him a little bit in his intensity. But he did what he needed to do, and he won it first. Best he could do is get third. Come back and third.
I ask Miles Martin this question: is Tom Ryan a genius? Is Tom Ryan a genius?
Well, my ACT scores would say no. Not at all. I mean, I think when you're in it long enough, and you see people that come into a program, and you watch the way they train, the way they live, the way they think, their habits. Early on, as a staff, we saw something incredibly special in Miles. And we felt like we did with Nathan last year. The losses, he'll learn from them, and he'll grow. He's somebody that will use a loss as a positive. Not everybody does that, and he did. He worked on the things that he needed to work on. Ross Thatcher did a tremendous job with him. Ross Thatcher is a great upper weight coach. And he really helped Miles a lot with some little things that he needed. So, you know, we make a decision to pull him. There's a lot of questioning why we would. Dumb move, this and that. And you never know how it's going to work out, right? You never know. But you move with a decision based on all the observation you had at the time. And you move forward and you don't look back. And that was the decision. We saw enough things to think that this kid can win the national tournament with a year of college wrestling under his belt. And we're fortunate right now it turned out the way that we had anticipated it turning out.
I look at Jeff Jordan's one of the best coaches, high school or college, in the country. You are coaching his two sons. I don't think Jeff Jordan is their coach now. He is their dad.
Yeah.
How huge has that been for you to have him be their dad and not their coach? He doesn't meddle in anything you do. The guy has complete faith in you. How huge is that, and what's that mean?
It's big. I mean, Jeff's an amazing coach, obviously. Won the last 17 is at the state championships. Many of his student athletes are in here, All-American. So, having his trust is important to me. And he has never once called me. He's a lesson in how to parent and send your kids off to school. And which is why Mike is heartbreaking. Quarterfinal loss and then wrestle back loss. I mean, those you take incredibly personal. I thought for sure Mike was going to be positioned to win this thing. And he was. It's so competitive. In that quarterfinal match, he's a takedown called off. If he gets it, he may be in the semis. He gets the winning takedown, and with 3 seconds left, he gets reversed, and he's in the semifinals. So it's a matter of seconds either way. And there's some painful stuff, to be quite frank. You know, it's painful watching someone that you care about, and he's done everything he could for the team, and he sacrificed for the team to go down to 41. Had a great season. To have a not all-American was pretty painful for us as a staff and for the Jordan family, I'm sure.
Speaking of parenting,
yeah,
you were doing a little bit of both this weekend. I thought things could have gone very differently in the JoJo Smith match for your son. Jake Ryan, you know, had a great year for you guys. Was ranked in the top 10. John said it himself, John Smith. You know, you guys, kids are wrestling.
Yeah.
You wrestle Pat Smith in the final. It's just like this crazy, intertangling family weave of a web, right? Gut-wrenching loss. How do you handle that?
Yeah, well, the first thing is, as I said at the press conference, you know, there were 6 world titles and 2 Olympic titles between our families. Right? Unfortunately, on this side. You know, when you wrestle with Smith, you know you're going to get absolute passion. And so with that match, there were some tough calls, right? But credit JoJo, down by a lot to some degree late in the match, to keep coming. Then he wouldn't keep coming. He kept coming and he got a couple of calls. My son has to do a better job with his overall fitness level and staying in completely intense and engaged in the matches. He's a freshman that wasn't able to do that. Miles Martin was. Michael Jordan needs a little bit of work there too. So you fight every second. Every second matters. And I think I'm excited about Jake. But hopefully it does some soul searching, both he and Micah. And the next 365 days will reveal how much pain they really were in.
Snyder, all-time great in my opinion. I think we're going to see one of the greatest careers ever. Bruce Baumgartner-esque, John Smith-esque. I know I'm putting a lot on him right there, Coach.
Yeah.
But you brought that guy out. You know, he gets 6 matches in before this tournament. He's wrestling a guy who's chasing his 3rd title.
Yeah.
I mean, it's the last match. It's not a mistake that it's the last match.
Yeah.
How huge has Kyle Snyder been?
Well, the beauty of it all, first of all, when we discussed it with him, you know, it was his choice, right? Same thing with Miles Martin. I mean, it was their independent choice. It was us discussing, here's what it looks like to us. Take this information, talk with your family, gather more information, make a decision. So he jumped at the opportunity because he realized that it didn't affect his freestyle training, it didn't affect his freestyle competing, and it would actually help him from a competitive standpoint getting more matches in. That formula helped him last year make the world team and win the world championship. So we start with the same formula. I mean, he's a great leader. He's tremendous. Ironically, or not, tonight, we are down 3 to Iowa for 3rd. And we are down 4 to Virginia Tech, I believe. So a win in the finals was 4 points. So not only is this, again, about Kyle winning his first national title, it's also about the Buckeyes. With a win by either he or Miles, we will finish in 3rd. We can't get 2nd, we can't get 1st, we can get 3rd. If they both win, and one Iowa guy wins, we can secure 3rd. If one of them wins, we get 4th. So there's a lot of team aspect of this thing still in play with the finalists. Virginia Tech is done scoring. They have no finalists. Iowa has 3, I believe. So, there's more than just a heavyweight battle at stake. It could come down to a win secures us a trophy.
Last thing. Here at the Garden, you're from Long Island. What's this been like coming basically home? Are you an hour away?
Yeah, 45 minutes.
You know, Hofstra, first head coaching job. Your family, you raised a family in Long Island.
Yeah.
What's this been like for you coming back?
Special, you know, as a kid growing up with not much. You know, I had some wrestling shoes and a headgear and a big wheel and a fishing pole and an inflatable boat I could fish in the near lake by my house. Getting to Madison Square Garden wasn't something that a middle income family could do, right? You watched the Knicks, you know, on TV, and you watched the Rangers and the Globetrotters. Being here, competing with the team, coming back to Long Island, pretty special. And my brother and I got to compete at New York AC a couple times and train there. But it's been a pretty awesome experience.
All right, Coach. Thanks for taking the time. You got anything else?
Thanks, buddy. No.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.